It's very good morning. Next pattern is memento pattern. So this is also a object behavioral pattern. So generally you all know that behavioral patterns means interaction between the classes and objects. So this is also one of the pattern which makes the interaction between classes and objects. Next, coming to our templates, the first template is intent. So intent means a short answer or meaning of the pattern. So generally intent of memento pattern is without violating encapsulation, capture and externalize an object's internal state so that the object can be restored to its state later. So generally we can say this in one single line, like restoring an object's internal state. The best example I already told you in the catalog of a design pattern. So memento means restoring the object's internal state. The best example is nothing but a recyclic bin. If we delete any file or any document we can restore that document by making some command like undo command. So by performing the undo, we can restore that document where that document is actually deleted. So this is the best example for this total entire memento pattern. And next coming to the, it is also known as token. And next coming to the motivation. First, what is meant by token? Why it is called a token? Generally, we all know that token means issuing some tokens, scheduling some tokens. So here, if there is any tokens to be issued, so that based on that token, the restoring can be done as an object's internal state. So that's why it is also known as token. And next, coming to the next template is motivation. So here, defining motivation, like what the problem defines, how the design problem defines, and how design problem will be solved by using what mechanisms, by using what techniques the design problem will be solved. And sometimes it is necessary to record the internal state of an object. This is required when implementing checkpoints and undo mechanisms. So generally, I already told you that undo mechanism. Before that, first, what is meant by checkpoint? So if we place a checkpoint in some places, up to that there is no testing will be done and there is no error. So that's why that is the implementing. This is required when checkpoints is implementing. Whenever the checkpoints is implementing or undo mechanisms is going, we have to record the internal state of an object. So if we need restoring of that internal state of an object anywhere, we'll use this pattern. Such design problem will be solved by this memento pattern. If we consider an example as a graphical editor, it supports the connectivity between the objects. So generally, if we take the two rectangles and that rectangle can be connected with a line. So whenever that object moves, then that rectangle also moves based on that connectivity. That is nothing but whenever that line moves, if we perform the undo mechanism, then it will restore the normal state. For example, see the diagram. This is the motivation diagram which defines everything. Next, coming to the applicability, where the pattern is going to be applied, in what way the pattern is going to be applied. So use the memento pattern when two ways, two applicabilities, two situations. One is snapshot and another one is direct interface to obtaining the state would expose implementation details. For example, snapshot. You all know that snapshot. If you take any application or a document of a particular, any document or any application, if you take any screenshot, like a screenshot, that is, and for example, it is a duplicate one which can be restored as an internal state. So that's if you want to take any snapshot of an object, this state must be saved. So the state of the particular internal state must be saved. So when the user wants to restore that internal state, then this pattern performs one of the applies where the design problem needs to solve such type of problem. by taking the snapshot of an object internal state by restoring that object internal state. So this is one of the applicability. Next, coming to the second point, it is a direct interface to obtaining the state would expose implementation detail. So if you take any implementation details, that implementation details should perform the exposing whenever the direct interface is to be obtained. So in that situation also we'll use the memento pattern. It is a direct interface to obtaining the state would expose implementation details to implementation details and break the object's encapsulation. So encapsulation will be break. So you all know that encapsulation means combining all the objects into a single entity. So it performs the breaks the object internal states. So in this situation we'll apply the applicability. So apply the sorry in this situation we'll apply the memento pattern. Next, coming to the next template, structure. So this is the structure of memento pattern. So originator, memento, caretaker. Remember students, the only three objects we'll use in this, one is originator, one is memento, one is caretaker. So this is the structure. And if you see this structure, so remember some words: originator as a solver state, memento as a constraint solver, whatever the condition we are going to be used. Caretaker is nothing but whatever the mechanism we are doing, undo mechanism. So performing the undo mechanism, constraint solver will solve the originator state. So this is the process which defined by the memento pattern. This is the structure: originator, memento, and caretaker. Next, coming to the participants. So here the participants: memento, caretaker, and originator. So memento defines the solver state, which is going to be solved as a solver state. Originator defines as a condition solver, whatever the user needs to be restored. That is the originator. And memento helps to restore that state. So that is nothing but a solver state. And caretaker is nothing but what the processing we are performing. That is the undo mechanism. So next, this is the participants, who are the participated as classes and objects. Next template is collaboration. So collaboration: a caretaker requests a memento from an originator, holds it for a time, and passes it back to the originator. So see, a caretaker requests a memento, whatever the restoring can be performed from as an object internal state, that caretaker requests as the undo mechanism to the memento from an originator. Originator performs what to be solved. It holds for a time and passes it back to the originator. Then the restoring can be done by the memento, and caretaker performs this mechanism as an undo mechanism. So you all understand about this collaborations. Next, coming to the next template. Next template is consequences, nothing but results. How, in what way the pattern is applied, what is the result we are facing. So these are the three results: preserving encapsulation boundaries. Preserving encapsulation boundaries, it simplifies the originator, defining narrow and wide interfaces. So these are all the consequences which faces when this pattern is applied. So first one is preserving encapsulation boundaries. So generally memento avoids exposing information that only an originator should manage, but that must be stored outside the originator. So if we preserve some whatever the objects internals internal objects can be preserved, that object can be encapsulated as a boundaries. So if we perform as a boundaries, there is a limit of objects restorable. So that's why in this, if we perform the boundaries, you can expect the better results when this pattern is applied. So this is one of the consequences we are facing when this pattern is applied. Next, coming to the simplifies originator. So by simplifying the originator, in other encapsulation preserving, other preserving encapsulation boundary. The another one is simplifying the originator. Originator keeps the version of internal state that clients may request. Client have request. So clients, whatever the clients request, originator keeps every information as a track or as a record. So that put all the storage management burden on originator. So originator has so much burden about this information, what to be restored as an undo mechanism. Then having clients manage the state, they ask for simplifies originator and keeps clients from having to notify originators when they are done. So that's why to simplify, by performing the simplifying and as originator, we can face better results when this consequence is faced by the clients. So this is one of the consequences, and you can say this is also one of the implementation technique also. By simplifying originator, we can implement this pattern also, you can say. Remember that you can write in the implementation technique also. The next one is defining narrow and wide interfaces. By performing the, I already told you in the applicability, defining an interface, obtaining an interface. So that interface should be narrow and wide. So by defining wide and narrow interfaces, we can expect the better results. It may be difficult in some languages to ensure that only the originator can access the memento state. So that's why by defining narrow interface, wide interface also can expect the better results when this pattern is applied. So this is the consequences. Next, coming to the implementation technique, two implementation technique by supporting the language by storing incremental changes. So generally mementos have two interfaces. I already told you, one is narrow interface and wide interface. Wide interface for originators and narrow interface for another object. Wide interface only for originator and narrow interface for another object. That if you take the C++ language, not only C++, so all the language can be supported by this memento pattern. So if you take the C++, support two levels of static protection. It supports the two levels of static protection as a wide interface and narrow interface. So generally let you do this by making the originator a friend of memento and making memento's wide interface private. Only the narrow interface should be declared public. So here we're defining the C++ language support. In that C++ language, there is an originator support and memento support. So both are defining as a friends, like friends. I am telling the example like a friend. So wide interface and narrow interface, two are friends, like originator and memento performing memento wide interface private and originator as a public, private and public. Too, by taking these two methods like privately and publicly, we can implement this memento pattern. So this is one of the implementation technique. Next, coming to the storing incremental changes. Generally, when memento gets created and passed back to their originator in a predictable sequence, then memento can save all the incremental changes to the originator's internal state. So memento can be saved all the object's internal state when there is incrementing ways. So by storing all these incremental changes by the originator also, this pattern is going to be implemented. So this is one of the implementation technique. Next, coming to so this is the sample code, originator public class. We are taking the originator, one is create memento as a method, set memento, so class is a memento, state get state as an operation. So all this the sample code. Next coming to the known users. So this is the known users. Known users means you all know that real time examples. So I'm taking one is graphical editor. You all know that we can write the best example for any pattern as a graphical editor or Lexi or as a user interface. Anyone, you can write the first known use as a graphical editor or document editor, whatever. So second one I'm taking here is the pre-order and post-order traversal. Why? Because we are performing the undo but to restoring pre-order or post-order. So this is one of the example. for the memento pattern as a known use. So this is the best example. So why? Because we are performing the pre-ordering and post-ordering. So that's why every client should, every user have to restore every particular state pre-ly or post-ly, whatever. So that's why pre-order traversal and post-order traversal students. You can write any example based on your examples, not only these two. Okay. So this is the known uses. Next, coming to the related pattern. One is iterator and command. So iterator, why iterator? Means every object performs, providing the way to access the objects as an sequentially. So sequentially is a pre-order, undo, pre-ordering and post-ordering traversal. We all use in the iterator, and this is supportable pattern for this memento pattern. So this is one of the related pattern. Next, coming to the command. So command pattern, by using a single command, we can define entire object. So here we are using the undo command or a redo command to performing the restoring. So that's why command is also one of the related pattern for this memento pattern. So this is about memento pattern. So if you have any doubts, contact me. Feel free to ask me, and thank you.